Hey guys, welcome to another VATSIM video here on the FS2004 AVH Pro channel. It's finally time to make a full flight again. As you know, I've been uploading a lot of spotting videos in the past month, but now it's time for another full flight with hopefully full ATC. It's another short flight. As you know, the previous VATSIM video from Bratislava to Prague was also very short. But this one is very short too. It's from Heathrow to Amsterdam. London Heathrow in the UK. Amsterdam in the Netherlands, and it's I'm going to be participating in the Friday night fly-in. It's an event organized by the DutchVAC, the Dutch division of VATSIM. And of course, it's always a pleasure to fly into Amsterdam. It's a great ATC, and it feels like coming home. So, but anyways, it's another very short flight, only about 45 minutes, I think. And of course, idea behind this Friday night fly-in is to do a real operations night, and of course to arrive about at the same time as the real flights arrive. So it's quite a challenge for the pilots and for me to try to arrive at the same time as the real flight at that night. This moment will arrive too. So the real flight will arrive at 20:40 local time, 18:40 UTC time. So, and the flight's about 40-45 minutes, I think, so I'll try to do my best, and if not, bad luck, you know, delay, it happens a lot. So, so thanks for tuning in here in this VATSIM video, and we're now going to do a little bit of a briefing before we hit the skies. So guys, welcome to a little briefing before we're going to make this flight. I've created this briefing pack using rocketroute.com. It's a website where you can do some basic flight planning for free, and also some professional flight planning for a bit of money per month. But I'm using the free version. It's good enough, and at least it gives me some basic information before I'm going to make a flight. So it's pretty nice. So let's go ahead and give this a little review. As you can see, we're going to be using KLM 1026, the Papa Hotel Bravo Golf Echo. I'm going to be using the Echo, that's the actual aircraft that's being used tonight as well. I've just forgot to update it. It's a Boeing 737-700. So this is going to be our route. We're starting at Brookmans Park, and then using lower airspace we end up at Retva. So we're going to be using lower airspace. The maximum flight level at this route is flight level 245. And we're going to fly to the east, so we're going to need an odd flight level. So yeah, the maximum flight level that we can use for this flight is flight level 230. Distance 204.5 nautical miles, and the flight time, I don't know if this is correct. I think it's going to be a bit longer. Let's just skip that and move to the weather, which is much more interesting, of course. Heathrow, Metar. Wind is 210 at 12 knots currently, variable between 180 and 250, good visibility, scattered clouds, temperature 18, dew point 13, QNH 1005. And then let's take a look at the forecast. It's going to be, maybe it's not going to be that good. As you can see, between 12 UTC and 20 UTC, it's going to change to some more heavy wind and gusting to 5, some lower visibility, 7 kilometers, showers and rain. So yeah, we might hit some bad weather when we depart at around 70:45 Zulu. So yeah, we have to keep a good eye on that, and yeah, expect some more heavy wind than currently is happening at Heathrow. Let's take a look at the weather at Amsterdam. Same wind direction currently, 12 knots as well. Good visibility, just some cloud layers. It's very cloudy here. I can confirm that. Temperature is 17, dew point 15, QNH 1008, and no significant change. So it's going to be quite good at Amsterdam, at least not as bad as it's going to get at Heathrow. So this is our route. As you can see, we're going to climb to flight level 230. I'll just skip this. Let's take a look at this wind chart. As you can see, there's some low pressure right here above Scotland, so we can benefit a little bit from that, and especially flights that depart from the south to the north can benefit from this low pressure area. As you can see, we're gonna have some nice tailwinds, slightly crosswinds, but at least it's not headwind, so we might arrive a little bit earlier than expected. As you can see here, the same thing. Now let's move over to this chart. It gives the pressure areas. As you can see, low pressure above Scotland causing the bad weather that will arrive at Heathrow. And here we can see this nice jet stream at flight level 310, where we can benefit slightly from, as you know. And there's some bad weather above France, as you can see. Icing conditions, some icing conditions above France, and yeah, on our route we're gonna expect some icing as well. So I'm gonna, I think we're gonna leave anti-ice on the entire flight. You know, it doesn't indicate any icing here, but you know, just to be sure. So that's a bit of the weather and the briefing for this flight. I think this is about it. Yeah. Some NOTAMs, but that's not really important now. So this is our route. Let's just move over here. Going to Brooklands Park, and then to the right will be a view on London. Yeah, we're going to be sitting in the left seat, so I'm not going to really be able to see that. And then a very short crossing of the North Sea, and then we arrive at Amsterdam, and we're gonna expect runway 18 right for landing. So this was the briefing, guys. I'm now going to have a little dinner before we move on, and then I'm gonna prepare the airplane for the departure from Heathrow. So stay tuned, and I hope to see you in the cockpit in a few moments. So hey guys, welcome into the cockpit of this Papa Hotel Bravo Golf Echo aircraft, KLM Boeing 737-700. As you might see, I've prepared the airplane for the most part. All we have to do is do startup, ask clearance, etc, etc. Luckily, Heathrow Approach is online, so that's very nice, of course, to have some ATC at least at the beginning of the departure. And of course, in the Netherlands, we're gonna have full ATC coverage, which is gonna be great fun. So the first thing we're gonna do is listen to the ATIS and yeah, get the latest airport info and weather info for our departure from Heathrow. So let's tune in into the ATIS. The frequency is 128.07, and then we're gonna hear what the ATIS guy has to say. So here we go, 128.07.
Pilot, Southwest, has caution when maneuvering in the runway holding area, as wind field clearance is not assured. Acknowledge receipt of information, Alpha, and report aircraft type and current QNH on first contact with Heathrow. Heathrow, information, Alpha, time 1650, arrival runway 27 left. Departure runway 27 right, surface wind 200, 13 knots, bearing between 180 and 240 degrees, visibility 10 kilometer or more, fuel 3000 feet, temperature plus 17, dew point plus 13, QNH 1005, delivery ground, and tower closed. For start clearance, contact approach on 119.75. Pilot, Southwest, caution when maneuvering in the...
Alright, so you might have heard, runway 27 right for departure. Information Alpha we have. We have QNH 1005 set as well in the... here on the altimeter. And so when we're departing from runway 27 right, it means that we're going to expect the, let's see, the Brookman Spark, which is that exactly, I believe 7 kilo, 7 foxtrot departure. Brookman Spark, 7 foxtrot. So we have most of our clearance already. And at Heathrow, there is a bit of a special clearance, how you say that, contact with the first controller. Because you're going to have to mention your aircraft type, your QNH, and also the ATIS information and your, flightplan clearance to Amsterdam. So, let's switch to Heathrow Approach, and then we're going to ask clearance, because we're fully ready, so I think we're ready to go. 119.75, 119.72 it is. But, 7.5. So we're gonna do a radio check first to make sure that everything is working, that my push to talk button is working, and then I'm gonna ask clearance right after. Heathrow Approach, good evening, Kilimanjaro 026 at stand 408 at Heathrow. Request radio check on frequency 119.72. Roger, thank you, and we have information Alpha, QNH 1005, Boeing 737-700, request clearance to Amsterdam.
2457, runway 27 left, degrees 13 on. Clear to land, 27 left, speed lift, wind, sense, wind, cockpit, speed lift, 457.
To wait a little. Clear to Amsterdam via the Brookman Spark 7 Foxtrot departure, runway 27 right and squawk 7253, KLM 1026.
KLM 1026, squawk 7053.
What's your squawk 7053, KLM 1026?
KLM 1036, is that correct?
Okay.
Squawk
7053 is set.
If
the APU running, we can disconnect ground power. Alright. So let's see our current arrival time. It's 18:28 Zulu. That's perfect. We're gonna taxi for a long time, of course, to Amsterdam, so I guess it's time now to call for pushback and startup so we can move on. So here we go. We're fully ready for startup. KLM 1026, ready for push and start.
KLM 1026, push and start approved, face north.
Push and start approved, facing north, KLM 1026. Means push back to the left, facing north, of course, because I'm gonna taxi to the north for runway 27 right, so here we go.
Please release parking brakes.
2457, welcome to London Heathrow, the gate right, enable taxi westbound for stand 512.
Take gate right and left at our stand 512, should be third. 457, thank you.
Left is clear, right is clear, okay to start engines.
Okay, we're gonna start number 2 first. Gonna turn off the panel lights.
0919, turn that left heading 1 at 20 degrees. Left heading 1 at 20 degrees, speed 919.
There we go. And we're gonna start number 1.
0919, 25 miles, 27 left, to descend altitude 4,000 feet to QH 1005, catch the back up. Send us to 4,000 feet, QNH 1005, that was
Speedbird number 9.
Parking brake is set. To be honest, I don't fly into Heathrow a lot. Actually, it has been 3 years ago since I've last flown out of Heathrow, so for me it's also a bit new. So I have to make sure that I'm texting the correct direction. So let's see. See what I can expect in the clearing.
You are clear for taxi. Please wait for my hand signal on the right hand side. Goodbye.
Bye-bye. So let's set flaps at 5. Heat's on. Generator's on. Can turn the APU off. NTI's on. Can set transponder mode to active. Okay, that seems also to be fine. Just start switches continuous and let's ask for a taxi clearance. Just gonna have to write it down a little, otherwise I have no idea where I'm gonna be going. EGLL 1026 is ready for taxi.
EGLL 1026, taxi right to Sierra, hold Sierra 3.
Taxi right, Sierra, hold Sierra 3, EGLL 1026. Alright, that was a bit easy. Just the first part.
Right turn 250 degrees. That's a moment, right?
Slides.
Turn right turn 250 degrees. Turn right turn 250 degrees,
be better 919. And I have to mention that I don't have my rudder pedals yet. I do have my yoke and throttles, but I don't have rudder pedals yet. Which is a bit of a shame, of course. But I'm using, still using the rudder of the joystick. The Z-axis, I believe. So it's a temporary solution, but they should be coming in somewhere next week, so.
Stupid.
Right here at
4, 5, 7, 7. 7512,
I'm gonna earn LMF. Auto throttle is on. The initial climb altitude at Heathrow is 6000 feet. Left here at Alpha. And we're gonna hold at Alpha Yankee 3. That's just an holding point before runway 27 right. So that's always, that's why you need to prepare very well, you know. If you don't really know the airport layout, you're gonna run into trouble, so make sure you give the little review before you actually are going off, you know, off to your next destination. You can turn the center pumps off now.
Cliff
take off runway 27 right, get 1026. Alright. Great. Everything is set. Alright. Everything is fully ready.
Good evening, EGLL Howard. This is EAW432 requesting IFR clearance for EHAM.
And take off.
Eighty knots. Can you repeat your call
sign only? V1 rotates.
This is Speedbird 432 requesting IFR clearance, EHAM.
What's the rate, Spirit?
It's 0432, I don't seem to have your vibration more on the ground. 0433, what do you mean?
Gear is up. Change.
Capital Approach, good evening, this is Skyway 1420, flatbed 738 at gate 258. With information Bravo on board and requesting IFR clearance through to Lisbon as well.
Skyway 1420, go to Lisbon, Southampton, Sea Fox, Shot Department, Squawk 7045, Heathrow Kinetic 1005, that's your passport.
Roger, clear through to Lisbon via SAM 2 Foxtrot departure, short 7045, Skyways 140.
Skyways 140 will be back correct. QLM 1026, contact air triple your passing altitude.
We're currently passing 3,800 feet. Climb flight level 140, squawk islands, KLM 1026. Okay, 140, set. Looks up.
Skyway 1420 is ready for a pushback at gate 258.
Back at gate 258. I still have my mind, welcome to London Heathrow, take it right, taxi left.
Standard QNH, passing transition altitude. To 250.
Left off,
rain. 508,
speedbird 919,
as we expected.
Skyway 1420, Christian Starr, approach face down.
Christian Starr, approach face down, Roger. Skyway 1420.
Skyways 140, confirm facing north.
Apologise, facing north, Skyways 1420.
Alright.
EGLL Tower, this is Speedbird 1 requesting IFR clearance to EHAM.
Speedbird 1, can you reconnect with Alpha Whiskey, please? You have to have ICAO to be Speedbird. Bravo Alpha Whiskey, please.
It's not really doing what I want him to do. Sorry, guys. Really know what's going on. I'll just fly manually for a little while. Monitor Unicorn 1 to do a decimal 8, KLM 1026, bye bye. No further ATC.
0132, Amsterdam, Britain's Park, Desert Fox, Sharp Departure, Squawk 7055, QNH is 1005.
We're having a bit of trouble with our autopilot.
Hello, Heathrow Tower, this is EAW432 requesting IFR clearance.
Okay, so that was a very quick departure. Yeah, sometimes things don't work out as you want them to do, you know. can switch to VNAP now. Yeah. And we'll just climb to our cruise altitude of 2000, flight level 230. There we go. So we are now inbound Brookmanspark. It's a VOR station, and there are some altitude restrictions, but we're also entered in the FMC, so I think that's why, you know, the VNAV mode went a little bit crazy. That's why I love Boeing, you know, you can switch the autopilot off and just fly the damn thing by yourself. So that everything is safe. I think everything is safe now. We're not climbing nicely. And we've been accelerating. So unfortunately we don't have any further ATC. I think the next ATC station will be Amsterdam Radar. Of course that's going to take a little while. Let's take a look at our departure or progress rate, sorry. And the estimated arrival time is 18:39 Zulu. That's 1 minute ahead of our estimated on blocks time. So we're running a little bit late because we're gonna also have to taxi for about 15 minutes at runway 18 white, which is quite long, of course. So I would have liked to arrive a little bit earlier, you know, to compensate for the taxi time, but luckily we have some tailwinds as we discussed in the briefing, so hopefully, you know, we'll be able to get a few minutes extra or win a few minutes of time to compensate for the taxi time at Amsterdam. So, quite a hectic departure, I'll be honest. So, we've got a little bit of cruising ahead of us, and let's take a look. It's not a very long flight, of course, but soon we'll be able to contact Amsterdam Radar to get some ATC again. We're going to expect runway 18 right. Usually, if you look at this chart, we have the Retfa 1 Alpha arrival. We're arriving from the southwest, and usually we have to descend on the using the normal procedures on the Retfa 1 Alpha arrival, and then at Schiphol we're going to be vectored to runway 18 right. Usually we're gonna have a very long taxi route to our gate. The real gate that's being used right now is Delta 49. That's where the real flight's going to arrive, so I've put that in the flight plan remarks, and I requested Delta 49. Of course it adds a little bit of realism to the flight to arrive at the real gates where the actual flight right now is arriving as well. And talking about the real flight, I'm gonna take a look where the real flight is right now. Last time I checked the Heathrow website, it didn't have any delay. It just was scheduled for a normal departure. So let's take a look at the Flight Radar 24 app. Great app. And let's first take a look where my position is. Using the VATMAP app. It's an app created by a DutchVACC member for VATSIM. It's great because you know, you can exactly see on the map where you are, and you can see all the traffic around you and the air traffic controllers that are online. So it's a great app. It's definitely worth your download is free, so go ahead and download it. I really recommend it. know if you can see much. You can see some ground here, but we're soon heading into or over the North Sea. So I'm gonna make a screenshot now. We are now flying near Colchester and near Clacton-on-Sea, as you can see on the picture. Now let's go to the Flight Radar 24 app. The moment of truth. Oh. The real KLM 1026 is currently flying. It has just departed. So actually, we are ahead of the real flight. That's no problem, really. At least our delay was not as worse as their delay. Probably because there's a lot of traffic at London, in the real London, of course. So, yeah, that's where the real KLM flight is right now. And, yeah. So we're going to have a bit of cruising ahead of us, and I'll get back to you when we're going to contact Amsterdam Radar. So enjoy the rest of the flight, and I hope to see you in a moment. So I'll just get back with you guys. Let's listen to the ATIS of Amsterdam to get the latest info, shall we? 132.97. Okay, information Bravo we have. As expected, we're gonna land at runway 18 right. Typical Dutch weather, just a few clouds and a little bit, well, quite good visibility. Transition level 4-5, that's the flight level where we're going to change to the local QNH. And information Bravo it is. So, yeah, we should be fine. As you can see on the map, just show it to you. We're are approaching Retva. It goes faster than you think. So in just a few moments, I think we're going to contact Amsterdam Radar. I'm just going to complete the FMC setup. Let's take a look. We're going to use 30 degrees of flaps. Speed 132. Let's keep in mind the missed approaches procedures at the runway 18 right are quite special. We're gonna see turn right as soon as practicable and climb to 2,000 feet and cross Echo Hotel 624 at 2,000 feet. Why we have to turn so right so early? That's because traffic is also departing from runway 24. So you know that might cause a very big conflict if we don't watch out. So turn right as soon as possible. And make sure we don't cross that Sierra Papa Lima 240 radial. Okay, so that's also part of the preparation. Make sure you also give a review to the missed approach procedures, because you might never know. As you have seen in my last video at Prague, I almost had to go around. So it's always good to review those missed approach procedures. Okay, I've just been notified by Amsterdam Radar, and here we go to Amsterdam Radar. Amsterdam Radar, goedenavond, KLM 1026, flight level 230, inbound Sulut.
KLM 1026, goedendag, red van Halfhagen, we vangen terrein, 3 cent to flight level 70.
Red for 1 alpha 18 right, descent flight level 70, KLM 1026. Alright, here we go. Flight level 70. Red for 1 alpha. So we're descending into Amsterdam already. The next frequency we're going to expect is
121.2. You're leaving my airspace. Don't forget ATC available this time. 50 change proof. Goodbye.
022.8, so Amsterdam radar cleared us for the Retva 1 Alpha arrival, so we're just gonna follow the standard route, and then at Seagull we're gonna contact Amsterdam Approach. We will be factoring us for an ILS runway 18 right. So as you can see, we're having some nice tailwind. It's gonna be a light crosswind. After Seagull, Sierra Papa Lima, Kilim 1026.
Thomas Cook 864, descend to flight level 200. Ah, Thomas 200, Thomas Cook 864.
Okay. So after Seagull, Sierra Papa Lima, as I expected. And what else do we have? Can I require some drag? So here we go. And we're gonna hit the clouds. The NTIs is turned on. It's not really necessary, but just to be sure, you know. It's quite warm. So it won't be a huge problem. But you're a Navier, sure, you know. I've had the icing problems before on this airplane. Here we go, right to Seagull. There are also some speed restrictions for this approach. We have to cross 15 Sierra Papa Lima at 220 knots. And of course, below flight level 250, we're going to be at 250 knots. 240, maximum 250 knots. So as you can see, there's an... deceleration points right here, and that's where we're gonna decelerate to 240 knots in order to comply with this rule.
KLM 1026,
contact Schiphol Approach 1-1.2, tot ziens. Contact Schiphol Approach 1-1.2, KLM 1026, tot ziens. Over to Approach. Approach, goedenavond, KLM 1026, flight level 110.
Easy 72, contact arrival now, 118.4.
He didn't read us.
Arrival on 118.4.
Schiphol Approach, goedenavond, KLM 1026, flight level 100.
KLM 1026, hallo, Schiphol Sierra Papa Yankee. And descend to flight level 45, information Charlie, expect Pegasus, flying bright.
After Seagull deck to Sierra Papa Yankee and descend flight level 45 and runway 18 right, information Charlie, KLM 1026. Gonna direct to Sierra Papa Yankee instead of Sierra Papa Lima, and we're gonna descend to flight level 45. So we're still on standard QNH, information Charlie now. Not sure what the QNH setting now is, but Approach will tell us that when we have to descend below flight level 4 or 5. It's a beautiful night sky.
Reduce speed to 200 knots.
Reduce speed to 200 knots, KLM 1026. Speed 200 knots.
Echo. After I did Sierra Papa Lima, I've maintained flight level 70. Information Charlie, expect vector child S 185.
Direct to Sierra Papa Lima, maintain flight level 70, expect noise runway 15, and also 1 November.
I'm gonna select flap 1.
Okay, level 1026, contact arrival 118, that's what followed by.
Arrival 118, decimal 4, kilo 1026, it seems. Super arrival, second frequency.
Easy
7, 2,
speed 1,
8, 0, arrival, goedenavond, kilo 1026.
Easy 7, 2, on present heading, split ILS 185.
G4
at Papa Romeo, Mickey 160, Matthew.
Hope you heard us.
Kilo 1026, good afternoon. He sent 3000 feet to QNH 1008.
Send 3000 feet to QNH 1008, Kilo 1026. Okay, here, did you hear us?
G4 at Papa Romeo.
QNH 1008 is set. Oh, look at this. Typical Dutch weather. No, a bit foggy and, you know, those lights. Beautiful, we're now approaching.
Speed
180 knots, KLM 1026. Foggy weather, few clouds. Beautiful. Okay.
Kilo
1026, descent 2000 feet. Descent 2000 feet, Kilo 1026. Further down to 2000 feet. We're still inbound Sierra Papa Yankee, Spijkerboer, VOR. And we're now flying over the Dutch coast. Probably gonna get a right heading in a few moments.
Right heading
150, cleared ILS, cleared ILS approach, runway 185 to kilo 1026. Okay. I'm gonna arm forelock first.
Descent
on the glide. Descent on the glide, Kilo 1026.
Arrival,
use speed to 160 knots until 40 me.
This is the one of the record of the day, descent to 2000 feet, QNH 1008.
2500.
And the runway, I can see it in the distance, very vague, but I can see it.
1026,
speed 160 until 4 DME. Speed 160 until 4 DME, Kilo 1026. Set the flaps at 10.
Motion for 1 of the Echo, the Sierra Papa Yankee heading 260. This regard. Motion for 1 of the Echo, turn left heading 270.
It's not capturing the glide slope yet, but...
1067 miles out, 5 miles behind a 320 number 2. Contact tower 6119.225.
Contact tower 119.225, Kilo 1026, teams. Okay. Here's down, flaps 15, and we're gonna contact tower. So with our goedenavond, Kilo 1026, ILS 18 right. What's your expected landing clearance, KLM 1026? KLM 1026, and I'm expected landing clearance. Once again, a late landing clearance. So we better get our speed down a little. I can see the aircraft. Yeah, let's fly manually. Why not? Flap 30 sets, out of break 2, speed break arms, everything is set. Let's go. Disconnect the auto throttle as well. There's some traffic ahead of us. Is he evacuating yet? Come on.
Schiphol Tower, VBS 481, holding short 07, runway 24.
Okay, clear to land runway 18 right, kilo 1026. Just in time.
VBS 481, runway 24, clear to take off, runway 190 at 9 knots.
Clear to take off, runway 24, VBS 1.
EC-7
to contact ground,
1.8. 100. Contact ground. Oh, I've shut down engine. Yeah. Kidding.
30. 20. 10.
Well. That means we're gonna taxi on one land. Stupid mistake. Alright, 60 knots. And I'll break disarmed and we're gonna vacate. And contact ground. As you know, at Schiphol, you have to contact ground by yourself while vacating the runway.
Stations,
and Superground is back. Superground, goedenavond, KLM 1026, runway 18 right, vacated.
Okay, around.
872,
press 8. 872, at 1026. Break,
KLM
1026, hold position,
gate 2
A320 coming from right to left. What's
your holding position, KLM 1026?
EG72, keep it moving please, continue taxi on current
start of engine.
And taxi to the hotel 3, correction, hotel 4.
Gonna have to text you for a
okay,
frame. This was such a stupid mistake. I just pressed the wrong button. I should configure my buttons ready. Sorry, guys, I'm new to the ProFlight yoke system, so I shut down an engine during landing. That's very. Let's think of it as a bird strike. So, let's see where this aircraft is going. Hope we can.
Okay, KLM 1026, you can continue taxiing now.
Continue taxiing KLM 1026.
Ceylon 1026, taxi to gate Delta 49er at Whiskey 5, cross runway 18 center, and via Alpha 1.
Taxi to gate Delta 49er at Whiskey 5, cross runway 18 center via Alpha 1, Kilo 1026, bedankt.
Kilo 1026, just to confirm Alpha 13.
Roger, Alpha 13, Kilo 1026. Okay, so just started raining at Amsterdam, as you can see.
The hotel in Easton.
And I've started on my second engine.
EG72 broke up in the middle of the transmission. Confirming taxi to Hotel 7 at Whiskey 5, cross runway 18 center.
I think this guy has another scenery, because otherwise he would be taxiing a little bit more that way. We're gonna have gate Delta 49er, and as the ground controller said, we can enter via Alpha 13, as you can see on this chart. Normally they use that taxiway for traffic that's being pushed back from the gate, but apparently there's not a lot of traffic around there, so we can make our taxi route a little bit shorter by entering via Alpha 13. Okay, so we're now crossing runway 18 center. And we're going to turn right here to taxiway Delta. So welcome to Amsterdam, people. It's always beautiful to arrive at Amsterdam. Look at that. Very nice airport. So we're now taxiing by the north to our gate Delta 49er. Alright, here, right at Alpha 13.
This
is the Delta pier at Amsterdam.
EG72, you have entered the wrong way. At the next intersection, turn left and then left again for Bravo.
Right here.
1.95, how 1.68, thank you very much.
1.76 to confirm
1.975. I'm
gonna get
Delta 51. 1.975, thank you. So we're gonna get 1.026. Is it okay that we get Delta 51? There's traffic in front of us at Delta 49er.
Galen 1026, I see you just arrived. Can you take back Delta 51, which is the gate to the left of it? You just gone there.
Yeah, we can take Delta 51, Galen 1026.
My apologies.
So we're gonna take one gate to the left. EG72, go straight ahead, please. Alright. Set the parking brakes, let the APU take over. And now I'm shutting the engines really down.
Next
station, Alpha 19, left for Alpha 19. I don't take any gate on your left side. So guys, welcome to Amsterdam. As you can see, it was a bit of a hectic flight. Let me first say goodbye to Amsterdam ground.
Blocks in position.
And Kilo 1026 is on the blocks. Fijne avond nog, tot ziens.
1026,
all right. So, it was a bit of a hectic flight. Maybe I was not prepared enough. As you can see, things can go wrong. Let me just turn the camera off. So, welcome to Amsterdam, and let's review the flight a little. We departed from runway 27 right at Heathrow. My flight management computer, it was programmed correctly, but yeah, there are some altitude restrictions programmed in, so if you switch to VNF too early, VNF goes crazy, he thinks that you're too high, you have to descend, or, you know, lower your airspeed, so I should have, you know, reviewed that departure route a little bit better. But of course, it has been 3 years ago since I've last flown to Heathrow. I was using the old PMDG 737, I believe, so please forgive me for that. Let me turn the panel lights on for a bit. And so a very short cruise, and at Retva we contacted Amsterdam Radar, and we were cleared for the Retva 1 Alpha arrival, and then to Sugal, and at Sugal we contacted Approach, Sugal direct to Sharapapa Yankee, and then further to arrival on 118 decimal 4 for the final vectoring to the ILS or runway 18 right. Again with a late landing clearance, just like the previous video to Prague. But I could see the traffic very well this time. You could see the lights and in the distance. So, but I saw him vacating on time, so there was no problem. But I shut down my engine, so it was probably my biggest mistake ever, shutting down an engine during landing. I'll just let me make a video to show you how it works. So guys, let me just explain this to you a little. As you can see, I have my throttle set up here. This is for the spoilers, this is for the throttle and for the flaps. But I'm using, let's take a look if you can see it a bit. I'm using these buttons to control the fuel switches on the 737. And apparently that's not really a good idea. I should fix something for that, or, you know, configure them in a way that I can, I don't know, have to press them for 3 seconds or something. So yeah, that's what happened. Really stupid, but next time I promise I'll fix it, and hopefully we can make a little bit of a better flight than this one. So yeah, guys, that's it. That's how a flight from Heathrow to Amsterdam works. As you can see, preparation is key, so don't be as unprepared as I was for this departure at Heathrow, and don't be so dumb as I was during the landing to shut down the engine. Yeah, shit happens. Better luck next time. So thanks for watching. Thanks for watching this video here on the FS2004 AVH Pro channel. If you haven't seen my previous videos, please watch them. My first VATSIM video, VATSIM full flight video, is from Amsterdam to Vienna. The departure video is with ATC. It's the same event. It's the Friday night fly-in event in February 2013. And the arrival video is without ATC, so you also know what to do when there's no ATC around on the VATSIM network. And my second VATSIM video, the best one so far, I think. It's from Bratislava to Prague. Beautiful flight with a very exciting landing in Prague. Also with a late landing clearance, so hectic, but it went very well. So definitely worth a view. So here are the links to those videos. And if you like this video, please give it a like. It helps a lot. And of course, share it with your friends. I would be really grateful if you did that. And yeah, we'll see when I'll make another VATSIM video. Hope a video where I will be prepared a little bit better than this time. And to another airport, of course. I try to keep the variety a little bit in those in the destination I pick. So stay tuned for that. Please like my Facebook page if you want to stay tuned with the channel and get the latest updates on the VATSIM videos. And hope to see you next time. Have a great day.